Hello, my name is Andrew Sandoval, and I'm a parent of four kids at Oasis Charter School. Just want to let you know that we have violated Ed Code Section 47606 regarding the LCAP, with only one meeting held last year within 20 days of approval of the LCAP, and this year we have no LCAP meeting scheduled. We have established policies that conflict with Alisal School District. We have violated our charter by not taking family surveys outlined in our charter, by not providing childcare or translation at our school at all times. We have failed to take state tests correctly, so have no scores to show. We have sent parent letters with threats of jail time and fines. We have ignored parents and their pleas to support their kids and their education. We have lost approximately 70% of all our credentialed teachers from just 2 years ago. We have lost 50% of our school's entire staff due to firing and quitting. We have failed to spend public money in a responsible way. We have misinformed parents about Title I funding swap program. We have a long history of losing qualified staff, caring parents, and students. We ask for Trustee Armenta, Cruz, Gilpas, Guzman, and Mercado, and Superintendent Rico to please visit our school. We ask that you please assign a new board member or representative with the same passion for education as all of you. 1 year when our test scores were low, one of our board members stated, maybe the smart kids didn't come to school that day. That's an unacceptable comment when our school needs help, our children need help. Our board president said, I don't represent you parents, I only represent the kids. This is a lack of leadership and unethical behavior that is documented through previous board meeting minutes. I just ask Alisal, your motto is Alisal Strong, to please help Oasis recover and thrive.
Buenas tardes, mi nombre es María Guerrero. Yo soy un padre de Oasis. Como padres no somos escuchados en la educación académica y emocional de nuestros hijos. Nuestros niños de Oasis están limpiando el plantel escolar, por ejemplo, baños de niños y adultos, de 1:30 a 2:30. Se les toma una hora de su tiempo académico. Número 3. Somos acosados e intimidados. Número 4. No se permite ser parte de la mesa directiva de nuestra escuela. Número 5. No se llevan a cabo las tácticas necesarias para resolver cualquier situación o problema con nuestros niños de Oasis.
Parents, we're listened to at the academic education meetings, and we're emotional about our children. Our children from Oasis are Hispanic, and in a level of schooling that is a good example. But for example, there are bathrooms for both children and adults, etc. And we are intimidated and feel like we're being threatened, and we're not permitted to be part of the school board or the director administration in our school. And they have not finished with the necessary tactics to resolve whatever situation is needed and our problem so that our children can attend Oasis.
Thank you. Hi, my name is Ruth, and I am a mother of four, parent of Oasis. In a recent board meeting, I expressed my concern about the principal hiring her sister as a secretary. I expressed how many have confided in the secretary, and it has later had negative repercussions. When the parents find out that the secretary is the principal's sister, they are shocked and quickly realize that why certain things have happened to them. I have taken it upon myself to be the voice for the parents on this issue. At a recent board meeting, there was a dad there ready to make ugly remarks, curse, and say nasty things. He is a brother-in-law to the office manager. He knew I was informing parents about the upcoming board meeting that was getting ready to pass an anti-nepotism policy. At the end of this meeting, the dad came after me, cursing and yelling at me for bringing that up. The staff did nothing to stop it until the kids came out, and one staff member said that, let's remember the kids are here. The USIN board did nothing, they just watched. Some of the staff members just laughed. Most of the staff had completely shunned me for about 3 weeks, gave me really dirty looks, and I'm pretty sure they all got interviewed with the principal to see what kind of conversation we've ever had and has tried to turn it into a negative conversation and add things to try and intimidate us. Following this meeting, I started to receive letters of intimidation and bullying from the principal. My husband and I are being falsely accused so we could basically keep our mouths shut. I come to you because our board doesn't care about the parents being mistreated and bullied. Please investigate the last 3 to 5 years or even farther on the USIN board's agenda in minutes. Several families and teachers have had the same problem and they are now gone because they couldn't handle the intimidation and concerns of their children if their children would be mistreated by staff for asking questions. To view our last board meeting yourself, it's on YouTube, Oasis Charter Board meeting in October.
Good evening to everybody. My name is Ron Santoyo. You guys probably remember me 2 years ago or around that in the renewal time of Oasis. And that day I was so happy that I thought that we were in the right school. But unfortunately, things are changing a lot. Like my other friends said, they found a way to shut him up. He said that I've been threatened to go into jail. Fines that, oh my gosh, this is scary. When the principal, Juanita, went to my daughter, I'm sorry, but I wasn't prepared for the speech. I hope you guys understand it. And also I have some disabilities too, but I will try to read it the most I can, sorry. My daughter, she came from Carnell preschool. When Dr. Juanita went to Carnell, she always told us that in Oasis, we are free to come anytime, any day, with no disadvantage. And, well, a lot of things happened last year that my daughter ended up here. She don't want to go back to the Oasis. I promise her that everything was getting better. This is going on not from 2 or 3 years. This has been going on for years. Unfortunately, most of the parents that were in Oasis, they are gone because they are scared, like they are trying to scare us too. Thank you for those shirts. This is for the presents. That's what we are asking for. I know that 2 minutes is too short to explain, but we will have more time in the future, hopefully pretty soon. So thank you. We need help. There is a big issue in the school that is happening right now.